Hi, this is Sweet June. How's everybody doing today? And I'm coming back at you with another video. Hoping everybody is having a blessed day. We're getting ready to go into 2020 or 2021. Thank God that 2020 is going to be over. This has been a terrible year. It's been a horrible year, and it's been a horrible year for everybody, not just certain people. It's been a horrible year for everybody. I think we can all touch and agree that this has been a terrible year for us all. And I'm so glad it's going to be over. Oh, so happy. I pray that 2021 would be a much better year, that the coronavirus can come to an end. And it's been horrible. It's been terrible. Just pray that this virus will come to an end next year. But, you know, if you do your research, the Spanish flu lasted 2 years before they got it under control. 2 years. So this thing can actually go on for another year. It could go on for another year before they can actually get it under control. But we're going to pray. We're going to think positive, and we're going to pray that it's going to come to an end soon. We're going to give it to Jehovah God. We're going to stay positive. We're going to try to keep it positive. And stay prayed up. That's all we can do. I've been on here on YouTube. I've been wanting to put more content on, but I've been going through quite an ordeal with my stomach. I really don't want to go into all of it, but I've been going through quite an ordeal with my stomach. Just trying to get that situation taken care of, and haven't been feeling well over the last few days. So haven't really wanted to post any content. But hopefully... I'm getting been to the doctor, and hopefully I'm getting it. My stomach issue is going to be resolved, and hopefully I won't have any more problems. With that being said, I've been on here on YouTube, and I noticed that a lot of black men on here keep talking about, as well as Kevin Samuels, keep talking about black women, or yeah, particularly black women, because they're always talking about black women hitting the wall. You know, that they're talking about us hitting the wall, us being obese, talking about our obesity rates, and hitting the wall, hitting the wall. We hit the wall a lot slower than other races of women. So, not quite sure what they're talking about on that. But, you know, anything to put us down and try to lower our self-esteem, it doesn't matter. And talking about this new phrase, we're average at best. anything to degrade us and put us down and make us feel less than. They don't care. And I notice that's being thrown around a lot. You know, since Kevin Samuels put out this video with this young lady telling her she's average at best, that thing done hit viral. Everybody's talking about it on YouTube, men and women. I did a video, if you go back, I'm going to try to put the link of that video in my description box there, when I was talking about him. I was very upset about the way he berated this woman. It's not so much as what he said, it was the way he said it. It was his delivery and the way he said it. And he practically cussed the woman out towards the end. He didn't have to talk to that woman like that. He didn't have to talk to her like that. He didn't have to berate her like that. That was not necessary. So... that's why I had a major issue. Wasn't so much as what he said, it was the way he said it. Everybody's entitled to their opinion. And I'm not saying everything that he was saying was wrong. I'm not going to say that everything he was saying was wrong. I did not like his delivery, and I don't like the way he said it. And he put her down in the process of him saying, him making his point. And that's not okay. You don't have to put people down and talk badmouth someone in order to make a point. And if you feel the need to do that, then, well, you lack maturity. Because when you're a mature person, you can express your opinion without putting someone down or name-calling someone. As people are doing on this video I did about atheists. Oh, Lord. People passionate about that. I got my first reaction video. A guy did a reaction video on me on that video. People are calling me stupid and ignorant and all that stuff because they don't agree with me or they don't agree with what I said. I just posed the question. I just asked the question. Why don't atheists believe in God? Simple question. And, you know, there was some people that was intelligent enough to come on there and educate me as to why they didn't believe in God without hurling insults at me. So that just shows, and I can respect that. I respect that. You don't have to agree with me. I don't have to agree with you. But you don't have to insult someone and call people names simply because you don't agree with them. They just have a different point of view than you have. And that's okay. We can agree to disagree. But it's not okay to call someone names, to berate someone, to put someone down simply because you don't agree with them. And I see that a lot people have a lot of that issue here on YouTube in general, but particularly here on YouTube. But I don't, as Michelle Obama and Barack Obama say, when they go lower, I go higher. So, but a lot of that, to get back to the subject, I'm trying to not get off the subject. A lot of those things are being said on here. And but my question, I have a question for the average at best men on here that have all these standards that black women should live up to in order for them to consider us marriageable. I have a good question for them. My question is, I see the picture of Kevin Samuels. He took a picture with his wife. She's a very attractive woman. And, but not just him, but all black men that feel that way, that have extremely high standards when it comes to black women. But when they go be with other races of women, of course they lower their standards. What if you get with a woman, a black woman, you meet a black woman, you marry a black woman that has checked off all your boxes? She's beautiful, she's intelligent, she's physically fit, she has no children by other men. She checks off all your boxes. When you marry this woman. But then when you marry her, maybe let's say fast forward 15, 20 years down the road, she kicks out, pops out a couple of kids for you or whatever, or more for you. Maybe she picks up a little bit of weight. Let's say she picks up some weight. Let's say she starts developing health problems. And as women get older, our metabolism slows down, so it gets more difficult for us to lose weight. Let's say she's just simply getting older, having a harder time keeping the weight down. Let's say she develops some health problems, because there's certain health conditions that makes it difficult to lose weight. not an opinion, it's a fact. Such as thyroid. I have a thyroid condition. I have an underactive thyroid. I think when you have an overactive thyroid, it's just the opposite. You lose weight too fast. When you have an underactive thyroid, it's the other way around. It slows down your metabolism. And because of that, you have a very difficult time losing weight. To educate you on that, I have an underactive thyroid. So even when I'm dieting and exercising, I still have a hard time losing the weight. You know, I can lose weight, but it's very difficult for me to lose it. And plus, by me getting older, you add age on that. Those two factors in there. I'm not making excuses. It's a fact. Let's say she's getting older, hormonal issues, she started having health problems, she's starting having a difficult time keeping the weight off. And she's gaining weight. She don't look the same as she did when you guys got married. And as time goes on, women's beauty do fade. Black women, we look younger longer, but eventually it catches up with us. The more time longer you be with her, the more her looks are going to change. When that happens, when those things happen, because beauty does fade. Let's say she's still the same beautiful woman on the inside. Let's say personality-wise, she's the same person personality-wise. Still beautiful person on the inside. Let's add spiritual in the mix and intelligence. Let's say she still has all those same qualities on the inside. But she's made her body, her physical body has changed. Are you still going to love her? Are you going to stop loving her, or are you going to be ready to divorce her? Because according to you, she done hit the wall. And now she's average at best. Because now you consider her average at best. Or she hit the wall, as you say. Are you going to still love her? Or are you going to be ready to divorce her? Or worse yet, are you going to go out there and cheat on her? And see, that is the issue with me. I was marinating on this the other day. That is the issue that I'm having with these black men running around with these extremely high standards that they have of black women. They meet a woman that checks off all those boxes, but 15, 20 years down the road, her physical body will change. It's not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. Are you still going to love this woman? Bible says a woman's true beauty is on the inside. It was a guy that it was on one of the other videos that I did. Can't remember the name of the video. He was saying, I should have brought my phone in here. He was saying, I didn't read the whole paragraph, because when someone comments to me and they start off hurling insults at me, I don't even bother to read the rest of it. Matter of fact, I don't even justify it with a response. So I just kind of skimmed over it, and what I did read was, oh, you didn't hit the wall and all this kind of stuff he was saying about me. He's saying I hit the wall and I can't get a man and all this kind of stuff. Yeah, I think he said something to the fact that I couldn't get a man and I had hit the wall. I didn't bother reading the rest of what he said. So that's the only thing that makes me valuable, what I look like on the outside. That's the only thing that makes me valuable. That's the issue that I have with black men having that mentality, or any man that has that mentality. We're not talking about other races of men. Right now, we're talking about black men. they are so focused on what's on the outside of a woman, but they're not overly concerned about what's on the inside. And that's a problem. Because which you should be truly marrying a woman for, you should be marrying a woman for what she looks like on what she is on the inside. Believe it or not. I know that initially what she physically looks like is going to attract you, and I get that because men are very visual, and I get that. But what you should be, when it comes down to marriage, you should be marrying this woman for what her qualities, her inner qualities. That's what you should be marrying her for, not for what she looks like physically. Because guess what? What's on the outside is going to change. It's going to change. Plain and simple, it's going to change. So, because you got some black men on here be talking about stretch marks and stuff. So you're not going to be with a woman if she has stretch marks? Even if her weight is down and everything, you're not going to be with her because she has stretch marks? Ridiculously high standards. So fixated on what a woman looks like on the inside, but not concerned about her inner beauty. And at the end of the day, that's more important. Because when the outer beauty fades, that's what you're going to have left. And that's the same goes for you. Your looks are going to change as well. 20 years from now, you're not going to look the same. I mean, us black people, as we get older, you know, because we're blessed to be able to still look good in our older age. But we're still not, there's going to be things that's going to change. I think I still look good for my age, but then there's a lot of things that has changed. And I'm not happy about those changes. But it is what it is. It's life. Our bodies change. And they're so worried about what a woman looked like on the outside, and they marry the woman that checks off all those boxes. And what if on down the road, she don't look like that she looked when you married her? You gonna be ready to kick her to the curb? I would not want to marry a man that wanted me solely based on what I look like on the outside. If that's what he's worried about, I don't want you. I don't want you. I don't want a man that's going to be so worried about me, how I look on the outside. But he's going to be more concerned about what I look like on the outside than what I look like on the inside, who I am as a person. I don't want nobody like that. I don't want to marry a man like that. I want a man that's going to love me for who I am on the inside. That truly loves who I am on the inside. I don't want a man that's going to be fixated on what's on the outside, because this is steady changing. This already done changed. This is going to change more as I get older. So I do not want someone that's going to marry me for what I look like physically. Because see, that sometimes when you guys marry a woman for her physical beauty, then when she does start picking up weight and stuff, then they start harassing her for berating her because she done picked up weight. That's emotional. Do you know that that's a form of emotional abuse? When you berate a woman about her weight, that is emotional abuse. It's a form of emotional abuse. Yes, it is. You berate a woman about how she looks and her appearance. You're breaking down her self-esteem. You're causing her emotional stress. It is emotional abuse. And I feel sorry for women that are married to men like that. I feel really sorry for him. I feel bad for him. And I don't want a man like that. Because they're constantly trying to change the woman. It's constantly, consistently trying to change her. Except instead of accepting her for who she is. No matter how hard she tries to keep take care of herself and keep herself up, it's not good enough for you. Because you want her to look like she looked when you married her. Well, she ain't going to be looking like that for the rest of her life. Her body's going to change. It will. Not a matter of if, it's a matter of when. So, I say those average at best men, the ones that have extremely high standards when it comes to black women, they don't deserve a beautiful black woman in my book. They're not deserving. They don't deserve it. Because they don't know how to appreciate a woman for her inner beauty. That's true appreciation and love for your woman, is loving her and respecting her for who she is on the inside. And truly understanding love. A lot of them don't even know what love is. It's long suffering. It's not insisting on its own way. It's in the Bible. It's long suffering. I know some brothers in the congregation. I have so much respect for them. I have the utmost respect for them. They married to sisters that has succumbed to health problems, and they're still hanging in there with them. They didn't turn their back. That is beautiful. That is truly a beautiful thing. I mean, you can stick by a woman no matter what she's going through, no matter what she is enduring. You can still stand by her and stick by her. That is the true quality of a beautiful man. But these men that say black women are average at best and we hit the wall, when they use those terms, they don't know what love is. They don't know what true love is. And they don't deserve an attractive black woman. Because if they, when they get her, they ain't going to be able to truly appreciate her. Because it's so fixated on what she looks like on the outside. Because on the, what's on the inside is what truly matters. Okay? If you're new to my channel, go ahead and hit that subscribe button, the like button, and the share button. Until the next video, peace and love. This is Sweet Jill.